Hey guys, it's Nano TV here again with another barber video. Today I'm demoing a video that I recorded today from a master barber named Sam. He works at South Trail Crossing Barbershop with me, and he's amazing. He's been barbering for 10 years. He's a master barber, more than 10 years, sorry. And today he's demonstrating a hot towel shave. So I want to talk about a couple things here. Basically, I want to talk about excelling your skills and your craft, because when I walked in this barbershop, I did not know how to do a hot towel shave, and I was intimidated using the razor against the grain. But after watching Sam demonstrate on how to do a hot towel shave, I'm now very confident, and I do hot towel shaves, not very good yet, but pretty good, you know. I haven't had a complaint. All my clients enjoy the service. And yeah, so I want to show you guys what he does, and maybe you can learn a thing or two. So I'll just be talking over and showing you, or letting you guys know the techniques he's using and what he told me while he was doing this demonstration. So basically right now, how he did his preparation is he applied a hot water mixed with conditioner all over the skin. And then he put a hot towel over the skin, or over the neck and beard. Basically what that does is that preps you for the prep. So putting the conditioner and hot water on the skin makes the skin nice and slippery, you know, nice surface to glide over. And then putting the hot towel expands the pores and gets rid of all the dirt, so you have a nice surface that's clean that you can glide your razor over. And one thing you see here is he pulled the nose up. What that does is that stretches the skin above the mustache area, and that's a great technique that I learned today that I did not know before watching this. So take a look at how he holds his razor. He's never ever applying pressure. If it's not cutting, he preps it a little bit more with a little bit more shaving cream, as well as some hot towels. Guys, before I started working here, I started working here 8 months ago, by the way. This is Canada's largest barbershop, so I'm just so happy to see how much I've grown and how far I've come in this industry in just a short amount of time, because you know, sometimes I don't give myself enough credit. I'm working all day and night, and I don't realize how far I've come until watching videos like this. You know, it's amazing that I'm surrounded by amazing barbers that are teaching me new things every day. And I want to give everyone the opportunity to learn. And that's why I voice myself on social media, just to teach people, right? All right, so take a look. He's got the steamer running 24/7 during the shave. And if you can see, there's two Q-tips on the steamer. And there's a little bit of tea tree oil, just so there's some nice scent. Okay, take a look. He just put his shaving brush into some hot water, and his lather's still on there, so it'll spread. And if you notice, he puts it over the lip as well. Don't worry about how you apply it. It's better to overcoat and just massage it into the skin. Don't be shy to, you know, get in there and make sure it's nice and lathered up. Okay, so right here, he's just kind of letting him sit for a bit before he puts the hot towel on and soaks that skin again and makes it nice and warm and opens up the pores once again. And while you're doing this service, you want your client to just relax and take your time. Do not rush it. This is a service that is a luxury feel, right? You want to take your time and make sure it's perfect. Okay, so as you can see, every single stroke he does, he stretches the skin. Except for that one. But anyways, you want to stretch the skin as much as you can, just so you get that close shave and so you never nick your client, because you know you don't want to get nicked when you're getting a hot towel shave. Don't worry if you do nick a client, because you can always apply some septic that stops the bleeding. And sometimes it does happen, you know, if they got really, really thick hair, once in a while you're gonna nick that ingrown hair or something, and then it'll start bleeding a little bit. But take a look here, he's stretching in every direction, And sometimes you have to realize the growth pattern of the client and shave in that direction. So that's what he did here. He's actually checking to see if it's prickly and hitting it again if it still is. So that's a cool technique just to see if it's smooth or not. And just take a look at the patterns and the direction he shaves in, because man, this was a game changer. Looking at the directions he shaves in, like away from the chin towards the ear to get it really close, towards the chin when it's on the chin, always towards the chin. Tell me if you guys want to see a hot shave from me, just because, you know, I'm learning as I go every day. And yeah, I think I want to show you guys my technique and tell me what you guys think. So as you can see, he pulls the nose up. That's the biggest takeaway you could take from this video, because I know a lot of people struggle with shaving that area above the lip in the mustache area. That's all you have to do, is stretch the nose forward, that skin there. Just do it while you're watching this video. Pull your nose up. Okay, when you're going against the grain on the neck, make sure your client does this. Instruct him to stretch his neck and point out as much as he can so that that skin is nice and stretched. What a service. This client loved the service. He tipped very well, and he actually complimented his service. So that's how you know this is a technique that you can copy and paste into your life. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching this barber tutorial. If you liked it, make sure you let me know. Follow me on social media. You know, my Instagram's Nano Barbershop. If you want to see another video and you have a topic on mine, let me know in the comment section below. Okay, guys.